I've been wanting to lower the rear of the Street Bob since the day I got the bike. Well, I finally got around to it, and it was a really simple project, so let's check it out. What's up, everybody? As you know, we've covered a ton of videos related to crankcase venting and sumping and all those other topics. I really wanted to do a fun, simple project, and that's what we've got today. If you saw my ape hanger video, you heard me say that the bars were either going to go up or they were going to go down. Well, I felt the same way about the rear of the bike from the day that I got it. The difference is I knew I wanted the rear of the bike to go down. And I looked at a lot of different kits and options early on. None of them really caught my eye, or I thought they were more expensive than was justified for what the kit provided. Then a couple of months ago, my buddy came across the Kodlin lowering kit. I took a look at it and I was immediately impressed by the look of the kit and the price point. This video is not sponsored. This is a relatively short video, but if you want to jump ahead, there are links in the video description. You'll also find links to the different tools and parts used in the video description as well. In the first part of this video, I'm going to cover the installation of the lowering kit, and in the second part of the video, I'll give you a traditional review of the lowering kit. Before we get started, let's take a look at the stock ride height. Installation is quite simple. I do recommend using a motorcycle jack and straps to make sure everything is secure. Jack up the bike high enough to get the rear wheel off the ground a bit, and then I put a wedge under the rear wheel just to alleviate some of that pressure on the rear shock to make it a little bit easier to deal with. Remove the seat and the upper frame crossmember, set the preload to the lowest setting, unplug everything that goes to the rear of the bike, pop out the cable retainers from the rear fender, remove the four bolts that hold the tail section, and slide that back to remove it. Loosen the small pinch bolt, and then remove the lower and upper shock bolts, and at that point you can take the shock out. The only hard part of this installation is dealing with the spring compressor. Now, Kodlin makes a great spring compressor. When I bought the lowering kit, their spring compressor was out of stock, so I had to just make do with this less than perfect kit that I found. It's not great, it got the job done, but it did scratch up the shock inside the coil spring, so keep that in mind if you try this kit. Let me pause just a second and say I really appreciate you stopping to check out this video. My name is Ron Chenal, and here on this channel I tackle projects of all sizes related to the bikes I ride, and I try to give you as much information as I can along the way. So if that's the kind of content you want, please be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and enable all notifications so you don't miss out whenever I post a new video. Let's get back to the lowering kit. Compress the spring far enough so you can get a 7/8 inch open end wrench on the jam nut, and then using that 7/8 inch wrench and an extension, break the jam nut loose and unscrew the lower shock mount. Set aside that plate that's under the lower shock mount, and then remove the rest of the parts from the bottom of the shock. Release the spring compressor, and then remove that coil spring. Remove that upper spring seat and install the Kodlin piece in its place. At this point, you should have removed three parts from the OEM shock: the lower shock mount, the base plate, and the upper spring seat. Recompress the spring, install the shock adjustment mechanism, install the Kodlin lower shock mount, slowly decompress the coil spring, and make sure that the tab on the base plate lines up with the notch on the shock preload adjuster. Add some grease to the bearings and O-rings and insert the bushing into the lower shock mount. You can then reinstall the shock. As I mentioned before, I put a wedge under the rear wheel to alleviate the tension on that shock. Well, you can use that same wedge to slightly raise and lower the rear wheel to line the pins up when you do the reinstallation. Add blue Loctite to the upper shock bolt and torque it to 80 to 90 foot-pounds. Torque the lower shock bolt to 70 to 75 foot-pounds. Put blue Loctite on that pinch bolt and torque that pinch bolt to 12 to 15 foot-pounds. Reset your shock preload to whatever you want it to be. Reinstall the tail section and plug everything back in. Recheck all your bolts, reinstall the upper frame crossmember and the seat, and you're good to go. Here's a comparison of the ride height before and after the lowering kit. You might want to take a look at the height of the rear fender relative to the rim. That's a pretty good reference point for comparing the before and after. The kit says you'll get between 1 and 1.5 inches of drop, but I ended up with a solid 1 inch of drop after everything was installed and buttoned up. Just be aware that it won't lean quite as far over on the jiffy stand, and you'll also drag that jiffy stand a little bit easier when you're really leaning the bike over in a turn. So let's take a look at my review of the Kodlin lowering kit. The price is about $160 depending on which model you need, and that is definitely a competitive price considering the quality of this kit and the other kits that are out on the market. The main features of the kit are that it's simple, you only have two parts, and it advertises 1 to 1.5 inches of drop. What do I like about this kit? The build quality is excellent with great machining. It is easy to install, but you do need a spring compressor to do the installation. As I mentioned before, Kodlin does make their own spring compressor, and their spring compressor costs about $160. So what do I dislike about the kit? There's really not anything that I truly dislike. I would love to see more drop. As I said, I ended up with about 1 inch of drop. The kit advertises between 1 and 1.5 inches of drop. I'd love to see a solid 2 inches of drop, but I don't think that's possible with the way the rear shock is set up on the bike. So I don't think that is a specific problem with the Kodlin kit. I think that's just the nature of trying to lower the bike with the stock shock and the stock coil spring in place. Do I recommend this Kodlin lowering kit? Absolutely. It's a great kit, reasonably priced, it's easy to install. So if you want to shave a little bit of height off the rear of your bike, this is definitely a great option. And don't forget that down in the video description, you can find links to all the parts and tools that I use for this project. And let me give you a little bit of a teaser for a future video. For a long time now, I've had this idea of making the Street Bob a hardtail. And once I got in and worked with the shock and saw how all the parts were set up and took a few measurements, that really sort of rekindled this crazy idea. I know. Why would I do such a thing? Well, like so many of the projects I tackle, it just seems fun to experiment with, and I want to check it out and see what I can learn along the way. So be on the lookout for that video at some point in the future. Have you installed a lowering kit on your bike, or have you raised the height of the rear of your bike? How did that go? What kit did you use, and what did you learn along the way? Drop in a comment and let me know. I'd love to hear from you and learn from your projects as well. And if you have any other requests for future video topics, drop those in the comments. If you found this video informational or useful, please do hit that thumbs up button and share it with your friends. That really helps the channel out a lot, and it shows YouTube that you appreciate this content. And if you're new here, please do consider subscribing, hitting that notification bell, and enabling all notifications so you'll be alerted whenever I post a new video. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy the ride. I'll see you next time.